In this video, we're going to be upgrading our version of Ruby. So we're going to be installing Ruby version 3, so 3.0.0. So you can see here that this has been released about 1 year ago. And before this, I've been using Ruby 2.7.3. So 2.7.3 has been the version I've been using for most of the applications that I build. But you can see here that Ruby version 3 is designed to be 3 times faster than Ruby version 2. So there is performance benefits that you can make use of by upgrading the version of Ruby that you're using in your projects. So in this video, I'm going to be using Ruby Version Manager, which is also known as RVM. So we're going to be using that to install Ruby version 3. And before we jump into that, if you are interested in learning how to write code in Ruby, make sure to check out the courses I have available on my website. So I have an intro course for programming Ruby for beginners, and we cover a lot of the basics in there to get you up to speed and writing really good code in Ruby really quickly. So check that out on the link in the description below. And if you're interested, I also have templates of apps that I've built using Ruby on Rails. And many people buy these and use the code as a means of learning how to build full applications. So those are available. You can access them all for $299 for all of those templates and use them as learning at your own pace. So let's go back now and look at how we can install Ruby version 3. I'm not going to go into too much detail, but there are some different benchmark tests and things here that you can look at on the Ruby webpage, which show the reason for the speed benefits or the performance benefits you can get from this version. So check that out if you want to learn more about that. But let's jump into this now in the terminal. So I'm going to use RVM, and the first thing I'm going to do is see what version I've got installed, just to show you. So do RVM, and we'll pass in the option of V for version, and you can see I've got 1.29.12 installed. So I think this is the very latest version. I've just run the update before this video. So you can run the upgrade using the details on the RVM website. And there are, once you have done this, this will allow us to see all of the new versions of Ruby that are available. The next thing I'm going to do here is run the RVM list known, and this will give us a list of the known versions of Ruby that we can use. So if you have updated the version, or if you've updated your RVM, then you will be able to see that we've got this Ruby version 3.0.0. So that is the latest version that we can install using RVM. So that's what I'm going to be installing in this video. So previously I've been using, I think it's 2.7.3, but maybe it's 2.7.2. But yeah, we're going to be installing Ruby version 3 in this video. So I'm going to run RVM install, and then followed by the version number that we're installing. So we're installing 3.0.0. And this will take quite a few minutes probably to complete, depending on the speed of your computer and your internet connection and everything else. But while this is installing, let's talk about why you may want to use Ruby Version Manager or an alternative like RBENV. So these version managers allow you to have different versions of Ruby on your system, on your computer. And it just means that if you have multiple projects, and if you're working as a Ruby developer or a Ruby on Rails developer, you're probably going to have multiple projects going on at the same time. And each of those different projects are going to have different versions of Ruby, different versions of the gems that you use, the Ruby gems. And if you don't have a version manager to control that, it can get very, very complicated. And you can run into a lot of problems quite quickly if you don't separate the Ruby versions in that way. So I like to do this by project. I create a separate gem, a gem set for each project. And of course, then there's going to be multiple versions of Ruby. So I probably have about 6 or 7 different Ruby versions installed on my computer. And I've probably got like maybe something like 15 or 20 different gem sets running on my computer. So you can do that based on each project. And that's how I would do it, and I would recommend it. It just keeps everything in the right place. It keeps it from becoming a problem later if you separate it out at the beginning. So this is almost finished installing now, and you can see we've got the version complete. So it's installed 3.0.0. Everything looks to have worked correctly here. So now that we've got this installed, let's run Ruby version and see what we've got. So you can see we've got Ruby version 3.0.0 as our default now in this terminal shell. And if I run RVM list, you can see that we still have we still have Ruby 2.7.3 as the default version, but at the moment we are running 3.0.0. And of course, you know, we've got all of these different versions and we can switch in between them based on what projects that we're using. But this just gives you an idea of, you know, different versions that can be running on your system at the same time. At any point in time, we can just tell RVM that we want to use a different version of Ruby. In order to do that, we can say RVM use 2.7.0 or 2.7.3, depending on what version of Ruby that we want to run at any particular time. So let's test this out. Let's say RVM use 2.7.3. And you can see that the correct version is now loaded. And once we do RVM list, you can see that both the default and the current version is 2.7.3. So it makes it very easy to switch versions of Ruby if you're using RVM. So let's switch back again. Let's say RVM use 3.0.0. And now we can see that the current version has been switched again. So now that we have Ruby version 3.0.0 running, so that's our current version, we can go ahead and add a gem set for that version. So if it's a current version that's loaded and you create a gem set, it will automatically assign it to that version of Ruby. So we'll say RVM gem set create, and we'll call this dummy app. And you can see that that has been assigned to Ruby version 3. So this just means that anything we install, like any gems we install, it will be contained within that dummy app gem set. And one really nice thing about using a version manager like this, and I think this only works for RVM, but it allows you to set the version of Ruby and the gem set within the folder itself or within that directory. So if you have a directory and you add a .ruby gem set file, you just include the value or the name of that gem set inside that file. And you can do the same with the Ruby version. So if you have a .ruby version file, RVM will automatically read these files and set the correct version of Ruby and the correct gem set. So that means that once you use terminal and you change directory, so you try to go into that directory, it will automatically change the version of Ruby and the version of the gem set, or the name of the gem set for you. So that way you don't make mistakes later, it will automatically load the correct versions. So that's kind of how I approach each project. I set those files and it means that everything's just handled automatically. So it works quite nice for all of my projects. And if we look at the Ruby website, we can see that there are newer versions of Ruby that's been released. So our newer versions than the one we just installed. So we have the latest version here is in December of 2021, so it's just a few weeks ago, Ruby 3.1.0. But this version has not been added to RVM yet, and as a result, we can only get 3.0.0. So there are newer versions of Ruby that have been released, but if you're using RVM, we can only get 3.0.0 as the latest version at the moment. Perhaps if you use a different approach, maybe you can update the RVM to use the latest version that they've rolled out. But I've just used the stable version that was released for the RVM update. And as a result, it will just give us 3.0.0. But I think for the purpose of just getting upgraded from 2.7 up to 3, I think this is more than enough at this stage. But let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And hopefully this video has been helpful to you today, and I will see you guys in the next one.